So now back to those holiday cards. So they need to hit the mail, but first, plan the perfect family photo. Do you dress up or go casual? And then what about lifestyle or portrait? What happens if the kids are acting up or the weather's not cooperating? What do you do?
I don't know. What do you do? Here to help us navigate is your wardrobe stylist, Abby Wood, and photographer Morgan Schimke of Morgan Jane Photography. Ladies, thank you very much for joining us today. Let's start with photography and staging. You know, what's the difference and what should I look at when I'm choosing, you know, portrait versus out in nature, lifestyle type photography? What are some good tips there?
Yeah, sure. Well, first of all, the portrait photography is kind of like your everyday stand as a post family, smile at the camera.
Like what we used to do back in the 80s when mama takes us to Sears and say, you better smile or
exactly.
else something bad's happening.
The threatenings, right? Yes, it's a very posed traditional kind of look.
Yeah.
Lifestyle photography is a little bit more those moments in between. Mm-hmm. Father looking at the sun, you know, everything like that. Yes, this is Abby.
Aww.
Yes, and her son Charlie.
Gorgeous.
And Scott. So that's more of a lifestyle photo right there.
So like you said, what happens in between those posed moments?
Yes,
so,
more natural, more organic.
Yeah, and how does a session differ between young and older kids? Because I mean, you're getting those posed ones with some of the younger ones, but getting those moments in between for the younger kids versus maybe your older teenagers aren't going to give you those sort
special
of moments anymore,
exactly,
right?
Exactly. That's why I think if you have younger kids, I would opt more for a lifestyle photography mm-hmm. session because, you know, they're going to be running, they're going to be playing, they're not going to want to sit and smile at the camera. So I think that those would be more prone to little kids.
Yeah, and then the best time of day to take our family photos, are we looking for that golden hour towards sunset? Is that still the right one?
That's still, especially if you're doing outdoor photography, there's nothing like that warm sunshine to brighten up your picture.
Beautiful. Well, let's talk a little bit about maybe like styling ourselves for fall. It looks like you got some great fall colors over here for mom and dad to be dressed up to, and for junior
and
as well.
For junior, yes, as well.
I wish I could fit into those overalls.
That's amazing. Well, whenever you're doing family photos, the first thing I always tell people to think about is pick a color, something kind of a statement color. And so that is my first C of family photos.
Pick a color.
It needs to be something that is good on everyone's skin tone. You want to make sure it's not anything that's going to wash you out. And something else you want to think about is if these photos are going to be displayed in your house, you want to make sure that it's something that you want displayed in your living room, and it's going to go with all of the decor.
Oh, so go with the colors that you already have there. So maybe pick out like that accent color that you use to decorate your couch with or something.
Yeah, exactly.
There we go. See, I pay attention to these segments, folks. Every once in a while, I'm learning something. You have three C's.
Yes.
That was the first one. What's the second C?
Second C is compliment. So you want to make sure that if you are doing a print, that they complement all of the colors. So all of the prints and the colors and everything complement each other instead of doing a matchy-matchy thing. So if I'm styling a family, I'm never going to put them all in the exact same thing.
So not everybody wearing red and black buffalo check or anything?
No, because it starts to look really jumbled in the photo. There's not enough depth. There's not enough texture. And if you put everybody in the same thing, maybe they don't all look great in that thing. And so this is kind of a way to kind of pull out different personal style in, you know, out of everybody in your family too.
And your third C?
Is comfort.
Comfort, of course, because you're going to be that way for a while, and then you want those kids to be comfortable too, right?
Yeah, there is nothing worse than being in something uncomfortable and then being in front of a camera too, because that is totally going to come out in the photos. So make sure it is something that everybody feels comfortable in. If it's kids, obviously like more comfortable fabrics. If it's, you know, a guy, make sure that if they're layered that they feel comfortable in it and they don't feel like it's something that they would never wear because they'll be like this the whole time.
Exactly.
So,
exactly.
So those are my three C's.
So do you have any other, just to switch back to some photography questions, any just great spots around town that you recommend when people go out? I mean, I know there's the Kauffman Gardens a lot of people go to. There's a lot of the lakes and parks around town are really great. Is there just some like nice, I don't want you to give away your secrets
hidden
either,
spots.
But just like hidden spots that you like to go to?
Well, my favorite spot is we live on 24 acres.
Is where at?
We live on 24 acres
in
my home. Yes.
Yeah.
So I have a bunch of areas out there, little hidden gems where there are tree spots where the sun comes through.
Mm-hmm.
And so those are my favorite. But, you know, anywhere around downtown or if you're doing senior portraits or anything like that, the urban area, that's the best.
Down in the West Bottom.
Yes,
some
find
of the,
a cool graffiti wall, you know, something like that. So, yeah, I would definitely just go with something that you're comfortable with that matches your family.
All right, very cool. Abby and Morgan, thank you very much for your time and your expertise. We're going to have some great pictures for everybody coming up here later in the winter and next year.